Within the central Andes mountain range is the largest magma chamber on the planet. Stretching across vast swaths of Bolivia, Chile, and Argentina, the Antipuno Puna magma body contains more than 500,000 cubic kilometers of molten rock. Much of this molten rock is relatively stationary at a depth of between 10 and 20 kilometers. However, on occasion, large sections of magma of dacite composition have traveled up to the surface, producing super eruptions. One of these recent super eruptions occurred in Chile, producing what is now recognized as the fifth largest volcanic eruption in the entire history of the planet. The volcano which produced this super eruption is known as La Pacana, which today still shows minor signs of activity. Although this supervolcano is best classified as extinct, its caldera contains two low-temperature hot springs, indicating that magma still remains far beneath the surface. The La Pacana supervolcano is located in far northeastern Chile, where it is 306 kilometers east-northeast of the city of Antofagasta. On the edge of La Pacana is a highly active Lascar stratovolcano, which derives its magma from the same at-depth massive magma chamber. The massive caldera of La Pacana measures 52 kilometers long and 35 kilometers wide and can be easily seen from satellite, as its gray ash-covered layers starkly contrast with the orange top layer on its caldera rim. Volcanic activity began at La Pacana approximately 11 million years ago when a series of andesite stratovolcanoes erupted in the area. Over time, these gray-colored volcanic centers changed as the underlying magma became more silica-rich. As the composition of newly erupted lavas changed from andesite to dacite and then to rhyolite, eruptions became more and more explosive. Then, a long period of little activity occurred as the volcano seemingly became dormant. Underneath its edifice, a large and localized magma chamber continued to build. Then, 4.2 million years ago, this pressure was released in a catastrophic eruption. As magma interacted with the glacial cover in the region, it generated a series of explosions carving out a several kilometer wide crater. Clouds of superheated gas and volcanic rock emerged from this crater and spread out in all directions, even traveling up mountains. As the surrounding landscape was buried in more than 30 meters of ash, the eruption seemingly paused. For some context, 100 years in the geologic record is a very short time span. Thus, when looking at core samples of this volcanic complex, we note a very tiny gap between two large caldera-forming eruptions. Whether this gap represents an hour, a week, or 100 years is unknown. What is known is that in a very short time in the geologic timescale after the so-called Tacano ignimbrite was deposited, an even larger super-eruption began. This larger eruption created a 50-kilometer-high plume of ash alongside pyroclastic flows which buried everything in an 80-kilometer radius. These flows incinerated everything and traveled up to 120 kilometers distant, depositing along the way a superheated rock known as ignimbrite. As a large quantity of ash fell across the high Andes, a wide swath of the volcano which had just erupted collapsed downwards, forming an enormous caldera. While the first phase of the eruption ejected 180 cubic kilometers of volcanic rock, the second phase erupted a total of 3,500 cubic kilometers of material. Over the next 2 million years, viscous magma which remained in the shallow crust erupted onto the surface, forming a group of 7 large lava domes. These dacite and rhyolite lava domes are all aligned along two implied trends of activity and occurred alongside the uplift of the resurgent dome. An additional 8th lava dome exploded in a spectacular eruption at one point, forming a 3-kilometer-wide caldera. After this occurred, volcanic activity at the La Pacana supervolcano ceased. Since then, other ignimbrite-forming eruptions fed by the underlying Antipuno Puna magma chamber have occurred in the region. One of these, Laguna Caldera, erupted 1.98 million years ago with a magnitude identical in size to the 1815 eruption of Mount Tambora, which caused the year without a summer. Although still quite large, this eruption was 23 times smaller than the caldera-forming eruption of La Pacana. At the present, we are seemingly in the middle of a long-term ignimbrite flare-up, which is currently ongoing a long pause in activity. Thus, while La Pacana will not erupt again, other volcanic centers in the region are likely to once again produce cataclysmic super-eruptions when this flare-up resumes. I hope that you enjoyed this video. If you'd like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new patron, Bliss Albers, for supporting this channel.